It's not every day we're gonna be the same way. There must be a change somehow. There are bad times and good times too. So have a little faith in what you do, 'cause you don't seem to realize the things you've got to face in life. You're up, tomorrow you're down, so thank God that you're still around town.
Errol Knight, citizen of Maryland, live across the river for about 55 years. But as far as I know, about 76 or so, the city come together and put a little walking bridge across. And it's been serving the public for a good while till it break down like that. It's made of a truck chassis, two truck chassis, some steel and concrete and thing. There, a little group used to be from, then a man that have a truck, Mr. Wang, he said he can get some truck chassis if he can get somebody to weld it, and then we get a bridge go across there that we can walk on. So when the river come down, it will be easier. Sometimes we have to sleep out on the other side for a day if it is heavy. Rain right through. Right. Even sometimes someone on that side can't come to shop. They try to throw money across to buy food. When it rains 3-4 days, sometimes it drop in the water, wash away. Two party measure it up. None of them trying to do nothing to it. They just measure up and say, they will come back, but none of them come back to do nothing to it.
My name is Sylvester Leng. I live across there. We call there Mind Peace. Well, I've been living here pretty 40 years. I'm 54, but I've been living across there about 40 years. Well, we usually just walk across the river when there was no bridge, because we didn't have such hurricane. But it came along now when the rain started to fall heavily. So they organize, we organize and get this little bridge built. Well, there was a little man who named Mr. Fidget. He does welding work. So we spoke to him along with, I think, the minister. Our minister up here. And we talked to him. So he do the welding work. So he get chassis, two chassis, and put them together with the citizen. And then we stretch it across there from stone to stone, and we build this little bridge with like steel and concrete. Well, a practical some house carry 6-8. I would approximately about 300 to 500, because you have some people live across up there, and if they cross up there, they come this way and come back round. This little road carries straight back around to a lot of little district. Well, it's pretty dangerous, but we have to walk on it until it goes. We are trying to do something to it, but so far it seems like we can't do anything to it. So we have to just be careful when we're walking on it. Sometimes the older people come and cross the little kids and see that they go off okay. And like when the rain starts to fall, the elderly people will be here waiting on them to cross them if it's that dangerous. It's not safe, but I say we have to trust it, because we have nowhere else to walk. If the rain don't fall and the river don't come down, we can walk in the water. But so far, if the rain falls and this little bridge is still there, we just walk on it. They haven't been doing nothing. It's just a citizen is trying to see what we can do.
Well, I am Nairon Wang from the community of Maryland. Yeah, over this side, it's called Mind Peace. Granduncle donate the parts, you know. Community come together and build a bridge. From youth days, been chatting on this bridge, you know, on and off. But a storm come around about the early 2000s and wrecked the bridge, and from that the bridge just keep going down and deteriorating, you know. No have no help from no ways and means to get it fixed back to the right level that we want it, you know. So seeking sponsors from wherever we can to get this bridge up and operating once more, you know. Well, right now, you know, the bridge don't deem safe, you know. Because you have kids walk on it, you have elders walk on it, you know. More time the elders, them scared them have to walk even in the water. Yeah, you know, that's not safe either. At night, you know, say, it's not safe. No way at all it's not safe, because at any time it can break away, you know. People can get damaged, and you know. Them place here, no money not there for insure and them judgment, so. We are going to end up loose same way. Yeah. Just community come together. Well, you know, it's out of our hand right now. Parts, like, for instance, material to build a bridge is very expensive, you know. As you see, the structure, decapitate, you know. Yeah, so we need engineer to whatever, like the piles and such. Yeah, and more need a driving bridge now. Yeah, driving bridge more be useful to the community, because you have people living as far as this a mile up from the bridge. Lot of walking that, you know.
Hylene Tomlinson, Marlene's mom. I'm just really want to say thank you, Marlene, for what you are doing here, because I mean this bridge is in this condition, I think, over 3 years now. We have councillor, we have MP. And every time they come, they send people just to do some measuring and say, okay, they will soon start something. Nothing has started. All they have in meeting, nothing has started. For you doing such a project like this, we are happy for you, because most of your family lives across this bridge. It is so important to us, because if flood come now and the bridge is not there, we just can't go across the river. So without this bridge, it is really going to be a serious situation for us. So we are so thankful to you, and I assure you not only your family, but all in persons who live across this bridge and have access to it. We are so happy for you, and I say thank you very, very much. And I just hope God will continue to bless you, and you continue to do what God wants you to do.
Yes, since Nicole 2010, the bridge fell down. And as a result of that, as community members, we saw the need to help in repairing, because we noticed that the powers that be were not doing enough. And we think that it poses a danger for ourselves and the children and all the residents across there. So we decided that we'll try to see what we can do as community or citizens of Manpeace to help and build a bridge. So we are now in the process of soliciting funds to assist with whatever repairs we can affix to it. Well, when I see kids running across the bridge, I'm very scared. As always, I'm always telling them to be very careful with in how they walk on the bridge, because as you notice, the rails and so on, they are quite open, and it's a possibility that they can fall through. And if they fall through, it's going to be very, very dangerous for them, as the rock stones in the river are very large. Marlene is putting on a pageant where she plans to use donations from contributions from the pageant to donate towards helping with the fixing of the bridge. And so for anyone who is watching, I would encourage you to go out and participate, contribute as much as you can, because we really need it, and it is going towards a worthy cause. On behalf of the Manpeace Citizen Association, I'd like to say thank you to the residents of Manpeace who have come out to be a part of this interview, to contribute and to support the venture that we have going on. I'd like to say thank you, and I'd like to encourage the participants of the New York Jamaica pageant as they participate wholeheartedly, because you are participating in a venture that will be for a worthy cause.
It's not every day we're gonna be the same way. There must be a change somehow. There are bad times and good times too. So have a little faith in what you do, 'cause you don't seem to realize
got to face in life.